Welcome. This video will be around the Users tab. We'll also have a personal touch project over creating users at the end. Let's dive in. We'll start by clicking on the Users tab. The first thing you can see is the username, as well as some icons to the right. The first being the log in as icon. This will allow you to log into any other accounts that are lower than you in the hierarchy. Next is the user properties wrench. This is where you can go to change a user's access or password. The copy user icon is just one over and makes it extremely easy to make more users with the same access by carrying over settings from one user to another. Last, we have the delete user X. While the user tab itself is simple, creation of a user can get a little bit more complex. For our personal touch project, we'll be adding a new user to our system. We'll start by selecting the new button in the top right of the screen. Upon creation, we'll always start in the general tab. I find it best to work the tab from top to bottom and then left to right so that you don't miss anything. Let's start by entering a username for this user. I prefer to always use an email. This way you know the username will always be unique. Then we'll use a secure password. While our only technical requirement is 4 characters, I recommend using at least 10 or even creating a small phrase. For example, "Stone Gator ate the cat?" ? Below the password, you can also see a password rating bar. Anything that puts you in the green is good and means you're secure. Postmask is only used for special use cases. It's a white list that makes it to where you can only log in from a single office. If you don't need it, you should leave it blank. In most cases, the creator will be you. But let's say you want to place a user under another user you've already created. You can choose to make that person the creator here. The account is based on the user and cannot be changed. It is only displayed here. We can also set the measurement system. Mine will be in the US. These next couple are going to be a little obvious, but for clarity, I'm going to go over them anyway. Can create items allows the user to create units, users, accounts, resources, unit groups, routes, and retranslators. Can change password allows the user to change his password. If this option is enabled, then according to the security rules, the user will be required to change their password at first login. Can send SMS allows users to send SMS messages. And enabled defines whether the user can actually log in or not. Can change settings applies to the user settings and whether the user can change their own settings. And now on to the access tab. Here, you give the user access rights to the objects to which you have the rights yourself. In most cases, you'll create a user that should have the same rights to all the objects you have. This is what I'm going to do now. On the left, I'll select such objects as units, and on the right, I'll select access template full access. Then on the left, I'll select my resource that contains all the reports, notifications, geofences, and on the right again, I'll select the access template full access. Now let's see the advanced tab. In this email box, we can place the contact that can be used for password reset and account block warnings. In order to get warnings about account blocks, you must select the checkbox that enables this feature. Now we'll move on to the logs tab. Logs is a way to see what users were doing in the system, when they were doing it, and from what IP they connected from. The message type is the user logs. Select the time from and the time to and press show. If this wasn't a new account, you'd be able to see the history of the usage here. Next, we'll go over custom fields. On this tab, you can add any information about the user, whether it's a home address or position of the user in the company. Parts of the fields can be marked as administrative by using the checkbox in front of the field. They will only be visible to users with the appropriate rights. In the left text box, enter the name of the field, for example, position. In the right text box, enter the value of the field, for example, dispatcher. To save a custom field, click the Add button. To delete, delete button. At the end of the dialog edit, click OK in the lower right corner. Congratulations and thank you for completing our tutorial on the Users tab. I hope by now you feel a little more at ease when operating through our platform. To further extend your knowledge of our platform, check out our other video tutorials. I'll see you next time!